Yo, Finn, where you at?
I'm here. Sorry about being late, Jordan.
Good morning, BHS. I'm Jordan Jenkins.
And I'm Finn Haney.
You're watching a special episode of BHS TV. So how's life, Finn?
Boring. I have no idea what to do with all this downtime. I miss seeing my friends, sports, going to the movies, you know, normal stuff.
Me too. The goal of creating this episode was to bring some sense of normal back into everyone's life and connect you to your school, friends, and community.
Speaking of community, thank you very much for supporting our schools and passing the referendum.
We greatly appreciate your support.
In our first segment, Didi gets us in the know and we hear from some of our BHS faculty.
What's up, Barrington? I'm Didi Brusis, and it's time to get you in the know. There's clearly a lot that's been going on within our school, the community, and our country. For this special episode, I thought we would reach out to the Barrington teachers for some words of encouragement and get in the know from the staff.
Hey guys, I know the quarantine is hard, but here are two fun things you can do to pass the time. The first is to hang out with your super cute dogs and take them for a walk and throw a ball around for them. Another fun thing is that you can start making food from scratch, like pasta. Hang in there.
Hey BHS, it's Mrs. Tileston from the Fine Arts Department. I have full faith in you, BHS, the student body, to be creative, to be strong, to be resilient in how we handle these challenges. Yes, it's a unique year, but when we have unique, large challenges, that's just an opportunity to do something special, to do something great. So please take this as an opportunity to show the wider community, to show the school, to show the nation who we are. We're Broncos, we are Barrington, and I can't wait to see what you do with this challenge before us.
Hey everyone, this is Mrs. Anderson. And this is Riley. And this is our advice for getting through our little quarantine here. My advice is this: do some work on your computer. Get things done when you need to get them done and ask for help when you need that help. Make sure you're keeping that social distance. The other friends that I'd like you to keep close are your books. And if you don't have books at home and you're not interested in those, we just got hundreds more put into Overdrive. So please don't forget that you can go onto your app, and the Overdrive app that's updated is called Sora. And we would love for you to have access to those books. Get lost into something, a world that is not this world. Take care, everyone, and please reach out if you need any support at all. Bye.
Hey, gang, Mr. Zimka here. Hope everybody's staying safe at home. You're keeping yourself active. I've cleaned my garage already. I'm working on my basement shop right now. I'm getting a little stir crazy. I'm looking into buying plans to handcraft a canoe. I wish I was back at school. Hopefully you're keeping yourself busy. We'll get through this together. We are Barrington. Go Broncos.
Buenos días, chicos. Soy señora Concha. Pues solo quería dejar un mensajito de inspiración y motivación y hacerles saber que nosotros sabemos que esto va a ser un poco diferente, pero que ustedes sepan que estamos haciendo los maestros todo lo posible para que esto sea una experiencia educativa y buena para ustedes. Espero que estén aprendiendo todavía, que se estén manteniendo saludables, que se estén lavando las manos y espero ver sus caras lindas muy, muy pronto. Los extraño mucho, chicos. No se preocupen, sí, se puede.
Bonjour, on va tous apprendre quelque chose ces jours-ci. ce que j'ai trouvé marche bien pour moi, c'est de suivre ma routine matinale normale. Alors, je me réveille, je me prépare plus ou moins à l'heure et après, je passe tout de suite une période de travail. Alors, j'espère que vous allez bien, que vous êtes en bonne santé, que vous prenez soin de vos familles, vos voisins, surtout si vous avez des voisins qui sont peut-être des personnes âgées. Et je pense bien à vous. Et alors, je suis ici. Alors, si vous avez des questions, n'hésitez pas.
Hello from Huntley Barrington High School students, Mr. Doles here. I'm out with my daughter Bella and our dogs Nayu and Storm, and we're just trying to get some exercise and make the most of our current situation. I hope everything's going well. You guys are keeping a positive attitude and enjoying the episode of BHS TV. Let's see if I can get my dog to say hello to you guys here. You guys want a treat? Say hello. Say hello. You say, I love you.
Thank you to all our staff members that sent in videos for this special segment. Although we may be dealing with so much, we have to remember to stick together, considering we're all fighting the same battle. Stay strong, stay kind, and stay well, Barrington. I'm Dee Dee Brusis, and now you're in the know.
Can't believe I'm actually saying this, but I miss school and my teachers.
In our second segment, 2-3-8 Reviews, Maliha will provide some entertainment recommendations on what everyone could watch while we're all stuck at home.
Hey BHS, I'm Maliha Amin, and welcome back to another episode of 2-3-8 Reviews. Today I'm reviewing movies on Netflix that we can watch through the comfort of our own homes. To start us off, we have a teen rom-com, To All the Boys I've Loved Before, starring Lana Conador and Noah Centineo. This movie was released August 17th, 2018. This movie focuses on a girl who wrote love letters that encapture her deepest and truest feelings. When these letters get mailed to all the boys she's ever loved, her life turns from boring to chaotic, and through a turn of unexpected events, she finds herself in a maybe real, maybe fake relationship. Here's a clip of the movie.
Wait, this isn't about Jen and me at all. No, this is about you and Josh. Are you kidding me? This is the reason that you broke up with me. You're still in love with this Bon Iver wannabe?
If Laura Jean broke up with you, it's probably because she's coming to the life-altering revelation that she's too good for you.
You're in love with Josh?
Margot, no.
It was such a cute movie where two teens were thrown together, and I definitely recommend it. It's definitely one of my favorites. We rate this movie a 9.5 out of 10. Our next movie is Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, which was released December 14th, 2018. Spider-Verse is about a teen, Miles Morales, a normal guy until he is bitten by a radioactive spider on the subway and mysteriously develops superpowers that can transform him into the one and only Spider-Man. Here's a clip of the movie.
This is a pretty hardcore origin story.
It's okay. We're gonna figure it out.
Were you followed?
No, I don't think so.
Real homie.
Oh, great, it's Liv.
This film was excellent and it won major awards, including the Golden Globes for Best Animated Motion Picture and an Academy Award for the Animated Feature Film. Spider-Verse had phenomenal graphics as well as an excellent plotline. Overall, this movie was definitely earned a 10 out of 10 from me. There are so many great movies on Netflix, whether you're looking for a comedy like Murder Mystery, science fiction movie like Inception, or a horror film like Insidious. With so many options and genres of movies, I'm sure you can find the perfect one for you. I'm Lee Hameen, and that's all we have for this week, Barrington.
Thanks, Maliha. I'm especially looking forward to checking out Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
Nice. Following the social distancing guidelines, Finn Haight creatively problem-solved a way to conduct an interview with Paige Wondrasek from Nuance.
Take it away, Finn.
Hello BHS, I'm Finn Haight. I'm here with another episode of People of BHS. Today I have Paige Wondrasek. She's a leader from Nuance. Paige, thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
So Paige, how's it going with social distancing right now?
Social distancing is kind of weird. It is a challenge to kind of keep up with everything and stay motivated. Especially I think a lot of students are confused. Fitzker said, like, oh, nothing can be graded. That's no work done over these days can be graded, but we still have to do it to keep up in our classes. So staying motivated is hard, and also just avoiding like going stir crazy.
I mean, when we eventually go back, you are the leader of Nuance at this school. What is that like being a part of that club?
So I love Nuance because it's an opportunity for all kinds of students at Barrington to share their voices, whether it's through any kind of art, photography, drawing, painting, 3D art, or poetry, stories, personal narratives, or memoirs. I think it's a super cool creative outlet, and also for the staff to be able to be a part of a publication process is really cool.
Yeah, that sounds like a really interesting experience. What's it like being the leader of that club?
Well, editors organize meetings for the staff. We're also the first people who go over these student submissions, so we organize those. And then when it comes to the layout of the magazine, we put all the pieces together.
Awesome. Wow, that's sounds really interesting. How long have you been doing Nuance?
I started my freshman year. Ms. Fleck, who is the teacher leader of Nuance, suggested that I joined it, and I did. I loved it. I continued into my sophomore year, and then towards the end of my sophomore year, I was on the layout team. So when we were actually putting together the magazine, I got to like, be a part of that, and all the digital work we do with it. And then I applied to be an editor. And now as a junior, I am an editor. So I do all the behind-the-scenes work.
That's really cool. Paige, this has been really interesting. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, and have a great rest of your I guess, break. I don't know. What is this right now that we're on? Yeah. All right, see ya.
Thanks, Finn. It's an honor to have the same first name as you.
Now here's Sahil with another episode of Exploring with Sahil.
What's up, Barrington? I'm Sahil Mithal here for another episode of Exploring with Sahil. Today, we're going to be exploring different options of buying food while staying safe, practicing social distancing, all while supporting local businesses and restaurants. The first and probably the best way to order food is through Instacart. Think of it as like an Uber for food. You can order groceries through your favorite local grocery stores like Mariano's, Jewel Osco, and Costco. Once you place your order, Instacart will have one of their employees deliver your order right to your door. You won't have to leave the house, and you can still buy any food that you normally would. If you don't want to buy food this way, you can still order your favorite food from your favorite local restaurants. Many restaurants are now doing curbside pickup, so just call, place your order, and pick it up when it's ready. You can also use food delivery services such as Grubhub and Uber Eats to have more fast food type restaurants delivered to you. Make sure you explore these online food buying options. Gathering in large groups at stores will only speed up the transmission of the coronavirus, so staying home will ensure that you and those around you stay healthy. Stay safe, Barrington.
Thanks, Sahil. In addition to distance learning and watching movies, let's hear from Annie Tifo on some other ways you can fill your time.
Here's another episode of Tifo Time.
Watching.
Thanks, Annie.
Now here's a segment on This Is Learning from Elizabeth Geraci.
Hi, BHS. I'm Elizabeth Geraci, and today I have asked a couple of students and a couple of teachers to send me videos about what they think about distance learning. Now let's go find out what they think.
A really cool e-learning project we've done so far is in theater class. We were studying Greek theater, and we made these cool masks, and we made a Meet Our Mask video, where we explained our masks and showed them to everyone, and it was really cool.
One thing that I really liked about it was that we could take the entire thing at our own pace, and if something was difficult, we could take as long as we wanted. We weren't constricted to like a 45-minute period, like during normal classes. And for my chem class, my teacher had us do a long multiple choice thing, which ended up being kind of fun because it was something slightly challenging and a bit more difficult than what a lot of the other teachers were giving us. As well, one of the best things about it was that we were able to ask our teachers questions over email or through Schoology, which really helped whenever I had a problem.
It's good, give me more time to understanding everything, and it's let me take time to just like keep reading it again and again.
There's always room for improvement, which is true about any type of teaching that we do, but overall I thought that it was really positive. Some of the things I really liked about it was the ability to be able to see my students through Schoology conferencing, which was really cool. I got to see some really cool pets when I got to see them online.
Well, BHS, that's all for distance learning.
That's all we have for this episode, Barrington. I'm Finn Haney.
And I'm Jordan Janke, bringing you closer to school.
One episode at a time. Stay clean and stay healthy, Barrington.